Welcome to MH class. Today we'll discuss some questions related to the relations and functions. Okay. First, we have to know about the antisymmetric relations. What is antisymmetric? Let A be any set. A relation R on a set A is said to be an antisymmetric relation if and only if A comma B belongs to R and B comma A belongs to A. It implies that A is equal to B for all A comma B belongs to A. Okay. If A comma B belongs to R and B comma A belongs to R, then A is equal to B for all A comma B belongs to A. Suppose, note, you have to keep in mind, if A comma B belongs to R but A, B comma A not belongs to R, then also R is an antisymmetric relation. As for example, we can take R be a relation on the set natural numbers, on the set natural numbers defined by R is equal to X comma Y such that X divides Y, for all x comma y. That means what? If x comma y belongs to R, it implies x divides y. Again, y comma x belongs to R, it implies what? Y divides x. This possible only when x is equal to y. So for all x comma y belongs to N, it is an antisymmetric relation. R is an antisymmetric, so R will get an antisymmetric relation. Okay, see question number one. What is given? Let L be the set of all lines in a plane. The relation R is R on L defined by this one. R is what? L1 comma L2 such that L1 is parallel to L2 for all L1 comma L2 belongs to L. L is the set of all straight lines. Okay, check whether R is reflexive or not. Reflexive means what? L comma L belongs to R, that we have to get. Now see, condition is what? L1 is parallel to L2. So for this, what we can say? Each and every line, this is L, is parallel to itself, or coincides to itself, is it or not? So for all L, we can say all L belongs to L. L is parallel to itself. That is, L is parallel to L. It implies what? L comma L belongs to R. So R is reflexive. What we can say? R is reflexive. Okay? Clear? In this world, each and every line is parallel to itself only. So some conditions, some basic concepts should be always kept in mind. Whatever you draw lines, each and every line is parallel to itself. So, this is reflexive. What you can say? This is reflexive. Next question, see. What is the next question? Let A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and R is equal to what? R is equal to 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 3. It is symmetric or not? We have to check that symmetric or not. Symmetric means what? A, B belongs to R. It implies B comma A also belongs to R. If we get A comma B belongs to R, that means that B comma A is also belongs to R. So see, the whatever the elements, we'll check one by one. 1 comma 1 belongs to R means what? We can say its reverse is what? B comma A means 1 comma 1. The same thing we'll get 2 comma 2, 2 comma 2 already, 3 comma 3, 3 comma 3 already. Last element is what? 1 comma 3 belongs to R. 1 comma 3 belongs to R. Is there 3 comma 1 belongs to R? But 3 comma 1 does not belong to R. So R is not symmetric. For a single element, if the condition is not satisfied, we cannot say that is true. Okay. So we are getting that 1 comma 3 belongs to R, but 3 comma 1 doesn't belong to R. For that, R is not symmetric. Next question. Prove that a relation R on a set A is symmetric if and only if R is equal to R inverse. That means what? If and only if R is equal to R inverse, that you have to check. So first, let that R be symmetric. First, we will assume that R is symmetric relation on R. Let R is symmetric on a set A. We have to prove that. To prove R is equal to R inverse, that we need to prove. Okay. Since R is symmetric, A comma B belongs to R, it implies B comma A is also belongs to R. B comma A belongs to R means what? A comma B belongs to R inverse. So we are assuming A comma B belongs to R, that we are getting A comma B belongs to R inverse. That is what? R is a subset of R inverse. Okay? R is a subset of R inverse for all A comma B belongs to A. Similarly, let x comma y belongs to R inverse, it implies what? Y comma x belongs to R, it implies x comma y belongs to R as R is symmetric. So x comma y belongs to R inverse, we are getting x comma y belongs to R, that means what? R inverse is subset of R. So from these two, for all x comma y belongs to A, this is 1, this is 2. From 1 and 2, or we can say, therefore, R is equal to R inverse from 1 and 2. From 1 and 2, you get R is equal to R inverse. When R is equal to R inverse? If R is symmetric. Now, if R is equal to R, we have to show that, let R is equal to R, we have to show that R is symmetric. Let R is equal to R inverse. Now, to prove, what is to prove? R is symmetric. That we need to prove. Let A comma B belongs to R. It implies B comma A belongs to R inverse. But R inverse is equal to R. So B comma A belongs to R as R inverse is equal to R. Therefore, R is symmetric. Okay? For all A comma B belongs to R. So R is symmetric relation on A. Hence R is symmetric. Therefore, R is symmetric if and only if R is equal to R inverse. That is the proof. Okay? So in this way you can prove the things. See the next question. See, let L be the set of all straight lines. L be the set of all straight lines. R is a relation on L defined by L1 comma L2 such that L1 is perpendicular to L2 whether it is transitive or not. Transitive means what? If we take three elements A comma B comma C, A related to B, B related to C, B related to C, it implies what? A related to C. That we need to find out. That means what? L1 is parallel to L2. Suppose L1, this is L1. L1 is parallel to L2, this is parallel. Again, L2 is parallel to L3. This is L3. L1 is parallel to L2. L2 is parallel to L3. That means what? L1 is parallel to L3. That is the. So what we can say? This is transitive. This is, oh no. Yeah, condition is not parallel. It is perpendicular. It is given perpendicular, not parallel. So L1 is L1. This is L1 is perpendicular to L2. Again, L2 is perpendicular to L3. This is L3. L2 is perpendicular to L3. L1 is perpendicular to L2. L2 is perpendicular to L3. So what we can say? Is it L1 is perpendicular to L3? This L1 is perpendicular to L3? Never. L1 is not perpendicular to L3. We will never get. Okay. Suppose L1 related to L2. And L2 related to L3. That means what? L1 is perpendicular to L2 and L2 is perpendicular to L3. It doesn't mean L1 is not perpendicular to L3. Okay? So R is not transitive. Okay? Next question, see. This one, we have to say, this is a relation, it is reflexive or not, it is symmetric or not, and it is transitive or not, okay? So first you have to check it is reflexive or not. So what is the relation R is equal to question number 1, what is R? Relation is x comma y such that 3x minus y is equal to 0, x comma y belongs to A. Okay. So if we write in the set build of form, table of form, what will get? 1 comma 3, 2 comma 6, 3 comma 9 and 4 comma 12. This is the relation. Okay. Now reflexivity. Here not a single element are there, A comma A belongs to R. Clearly, A comma A does not belongs to R. For all A comma A, for all A belongs to A. We are not getting this one. So R is not, therefore R is not reflexive. R is not reflexive. Symmetric, we can take any example from here. 1 comma 3 belongs to R, but 3 comma 1 does not belongs to R, therefore R is not symmetric. Okay, next transitive, if we take 1 comma 3 which related to 3 comma 9 is there, so 1 comma 3 belongs to R, 3 comma 9 belongs to R, but 1 comma 9 is not belongs to R, so we cannot say that R is transitive. Okay, that example we can say here. Transitivity, since 1 comma 3 belongs to R and 3 comma 9 belongs to R, but 1 comma 9 does not belongs to R, therefore R is not transitive. Okay, that means R is neither reflexive nor transitive nor symmetric nor transitive. Roman number 2, what is given? R is, what is R? R is equal to x comma y such that x minus y is an integer. This is the question given. Okay, x comma y is an integer, reflexive. For all x belongs to z, this is an integers, x belongs to z, what we can say, x minus x is equal to 0, which is an integer. That means what? X comma x belongs to R, therefore R is reflexive. Then symmetric. For all x comma y belongs to R, let x comma y belongs to z, for all x comma y belongs to x comma y belongs to R, it means what? X minus y is an integer, we can say. If x minus y is an integer, so y minus x is also an integer. So what we can say? Y comma x belongs to R, therefore R is symmetric. Okay. R is symmetric. Transitive, for all x three elements, x comma y comma z belongs to z integers, let x comma y belongs to R and y comma z belongs to R. That means what? X minus y is an integer and y minus z is an integer. If we add them, integer plus integer also integer. So x minus y plus y minus z is also an integer. So if we remove that, x minus y plus y minus z is an integer. That means x minus z, yy cancel, is an integer. That means what? X comma y, x comma z belongs to R. We assume x comma y belongs to R, y comma z belongs to R, and we are getting x comma z belongs to R. Therefore R is what? transitive. So here R is reflexive, R is symmetric, and R is transitive. Okay. So in this you have to solve the question. Last question for today's class. Show that the relation R defined by the set A of all triangles in a plane R. Condition is what? R is equal to T1 comma T2, such that T1 is similar to T2. We have to show that it is an equivalence relation. For that, first we have to say reflexivity. Reflexivity. For all triangles, T belongs to A. T is similar to T. Each and every triangles are similar to itself. Okay, it implies what? T comma T belongs to R. Therefore, R is reflexive. Next, symmetric. For all T1 comma T2 belongs to A, let T1 comma T2 belongs to R. It implies T1 is similar to T2. If T1 is similar to T2, T2 is also similar to T1. That means T2 comma T1 belongs to R. Therefore, R is symmetric. Okay? Last one, transitive. Transitivity. All T1 comma T2 comma T3 belongs to A. Let T1 comma T2 belongs to R and T2 comma T3 belongs to R. It implies T1 is similar to T2, T2 is similar to T3. If T1 is similar to T2 and T2 is similar to T3, so what we can say? T1 is similar to T3. It implies T1 comma T3 belongs to R. Therefore, R is transitive. So R is reflexive, R is symmetric, R is transitive. Therefore, R is an equivalence relation. So in this we have to solve the questions. Hope all of you understand. If any doubt, let me know. I'll try to my best to clear your concept. Thank you. Have a nice day.